This here actually, and then let the stream see it.
So, Secret does first pick.
10 seconds remaining.
Hold on. Oh shit. Alright, you can talk about the buns. I'm gonna do this thing real quick.
Alright, so at Venom usually bans heroes that are iconic for the enemy team, like in this case Cobble, plus maybe some Forest Hero or something like Juggernaut, I would expect. Because I think in this game, who gets Juggernaut and Nyx is really important. Because like both of them really like this hero. With yeah, magic immune
especially characters. Juggernaut, I feel. Juggernaut is like MP. This hero,
yeah, yeah,
that's
he
what
was,
you saw him play all the time in Epic as well. But it's,
he played it earlier today. I can't remember what it was with though. Like what team it was against?
I haven't been able to watch any of the
Secret look good, that, to be honest. They look very, very good.
I did see both Atchinim and Secret being 3-0 and 2-0.
Mm-hmm.
To be honest, if I would say like the teams that I would come out of the EU qualifiers would be Escape, Secret, or Atchinim.
Like yeah, this is probably the most hyped game of the whole entire day, to be honest.
The bans are so good as well from Secret. Like, those two heroes are the main cards of their Nyx strategies usually. Bounty Hunter and Bad Rider.
Maybe next time it's like, he loves Bounty, he always plays it. Like, if he plays it in
yeah,
all the time.
Remember
so
when
like
we interviewed him on the Dream League? And he said, if we have Bounty Hunter, we won.
Yeah, pretty much.
Like his confidence with that hero, it's just like so high, yeah. It's amazing.
It's kind of like a Jericho. Well.
Alright, let's see. Liquipedia.
I feel like we mentioned though with like Forev bans, I'm pretty sure they'll probably get more Forev heroes, like second phase. So like offlaners. But with a Draw Ranger, I don't know if they'll want to take out heroes like Kinder and Axe that are like Rev heroes.
It's gonna be interesting to see what Atfinim goes for now. They usually go for Wisp plus OD if they get that.
They
but against a Draw strat,
love Draw OD.
Yeah, exactly. They might go for something different. Okay.
They still like their Sven.
Oh, I haven't seen that in a while.
No, me neither.
Like Nyx, Juggernaut, Anti-Mage was mostly in the last games.
BA actually destroys Draw Ranger, like destroys her. She just probably the best maybe counter in the game.
I wouldn't be very surprised if they take Spirit Break your second base for maybe next time. To be honest, it's like Spartan plays Iron, then the Spirit Breaker, so you can be on top of the draw constantly, and you just take away the damage pretty much.
And Spirit Breaker is good for relocate as well. I think you go OD, right? If you're Team Secret, it's just safe. OD or Invoker. MP. Mid one. He does play both of them heroes pretty well, so.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think mid one usually likes more flashy heroes, so.
Like, you could wait, right? You could wait and pick him like a later hero and go for like Storm Spirit or something with Drow. Like Drow opens up your options so much. You can pick so many more mid laners, maybe even a Puck or something.
I mean, or even Invoker.
That's the thing with Drow as well. You don't even have to make lineup around the Drow. I've seen that in the past where teams have like, it looks like they're picking a Drow strat, but if you focus on the Drow, you just have something else.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like Liquid sometimes did like the old Liquid lineup where pick a Drow strat, but they would have an Alphas, and then you focus on keeping the Drow down because you don't have to push it 12 minutes. But when you kept the Drow down for 20 minutes, the Alchemist already is 5 slotted, you know, like 4 slotted, and then like 2 minutes later he's 6 slotted. So it's like you. Drow is like so much more than just a Drow strat and trying to tower it for 12 minutes.
Yeah, it's true. It's like. It's not you can even just like not do your typical like pushing strategy. You can just try and win your lanes and then play from there. You know what I mean? You don't have to go all in on the pushing. There's some like about a year ago, people were saying Drow Ranger was like such a, you know, you pick Drow, everyone knows exactly what you're gonna do. You know what I mean? But now it's pretty versatile. Like some people even fight with it and like go like BKB pretty early and stuff. But so far, Advinum's draft looks way better to me. Like, Io can kind of do whatever, he can roam around, make your lane strong. PA is just a strong laner, it counters Drow pretty well.
It's, and especially if it's an offline slaughter, it's not going to be as beefy as if it would be a safeline slaughter. Like, safeline slaughter usually is a bit bigger because you can go treads and armor. Offline is usually cool boots into blink. So we saw can destroy the slaughter as well, you know?
Yeah, we saw Lauda in the Alliance game. He went Tranquils, Blink, Force, and safeline slaughter.
Yeah, like, I saw that. I think Doom League as well.
I mean, he was basically a position 3 in that game. X got
That's true, actually, yeah. That is very true.
Yeah, but in general, so the PA can, like, pretty much destroy both of those heroes if he gets a pretty good start, so... Kind of, like, do what Secret takes as a
third core, PA is just such a good hero. Like, you don't even need... Like, your items are really cheap, you know? Like, your Deathso is, like, 3.5k, your Vlad's, like, 2.2. You know, all your items are really low cost and have really good build-ups, and then you're just ready to go. You know what I mean? You don't really need that much else.
Then with the Wisp as well, you don't go bottle, you just go Akua into like Deathso, just like start steamrolling.
And he only needs to like bottle you once and you're pretty good, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
exactly, you can just keep spamming daggers and whatever.
It's ridiculous. I like the Morana ban. I think their heroes are very susceptible to magic burst. You know, PA and IO, not exactly the highest strength, like strength health based heroes, but they're kind of okay against physical damage. You know, you can kind of kite people with IO, and PA has evasion. So like magical burst is amazing.
Yeah, it's like physical damage is kind of annoying to deal with because, or like it's easier to deal with because you can overcharge. You can like negate the damage constantly. You have magic burst, it like comes in burst, so it's a lot harder to like gain that damage in some sense. So.
Ricky, I'm pretty sure that he loves this hero too, like just as much. Maybe next time.
He just likes to be invis and run around.
Yeah, he likes the invis heroes, just to be a ball bag basically, like an ass. It's pretty funny actually.
Exactly, he just one of the pokes people, you know?
Yeah, until they snap.
Pretty much.
Shane, can you turn on weapons volume a bit?
Seems turn it up
quite low.
Oh, is this on people in stream saying this or?
Yeah, exactly.
I was turning it up. I was turning him up. I think it's good now. Because I was slowly editing it, you know, as the time went on, so like stream is a bit behind. 10 seconds
remaining. I think I feel it's just like super safe pick overall, you know?
Bane is weird to me.
I mean, it's like, doesn't serve a massive purpose in a way, but it's still kind of safe, you know? It's just a safe hero because you got CC, you got burst, you keep piercing CC, and you get damage reduction on physical damage, which is pretty nice with the feel.
Bane to me says Invoker. Like if I see Bane, I think Invoker. I think like Sunstrike. Yeah, I think good setup for a global kind of strat. It allows Larda to get in position. You can kind of roam to your lanes. And if you do sleep PA, like in the mid lane, he's just dead. Or even if he's safe lane.
I also think it kind of prevents a Nakes pick because they really like doing like stuff like Ricky Nakes. With safe lane.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, Nakes is so good in this game, actually, for Adfinim. You have two blinking heroes and an IO.
Yeah. Like, Slaughter Bane are alright against him, though. The minus armor plus Fiend's Grip, pretty good.
Bane is also nice to be a hero that you put into mid. It's kind of like a disruptor in a way. Where it's like, it just works to bring the hero to mid to help harass, you know? If they decide on running the IOPA mid still, even though they have the buck. They still do IOPA mid, you can put the Bane there together and he can just get brains at level 1 and just spam that out to like counter the harassment and the IO.
And when they change the mana cost of that, like 70 mana level 1, it's so spammable, you can use it like 6 times or something.
It's like 90 damage, it's quite a bit, you know?
It's not even 90 damage, it's 90 like damage and 90 heal, like which is the huge part, Damn!
That's probably a thug puck. But usually Spartan likes to run the safe lane IO, right? He doesn't run it together with thug a lot in mid.
No,
they
I
almost
haven't
always
seen
bring it to safe lane, but Spartan always plays the Wisp together with their carry.
Zero games. Svan, you're on point actually. That was top. That was a sick level fucking research right there. Oh. Windrunner. Man, Slider Windrunner is such a old classic really, isn't it? And then
destroy
you have
PA even though she's doubler.
They have Drow on top of it. Pretty legit, I like it. It's decent against Ricky, you know, it's you can kind of live if they if he roams, you have Windrun to kind of be a bit more survivable in mid lane. They ban Visage or Visage.
I wonder why, like Visage is not good against Phantom Assassin. Not at all. So no. Easy to kill the birds.
Io was very good against it as well. You know, you have fast attack speed with overcharge and you've no turn ray. You just kill the birds very quickly. They need a support. I think Spirit Breaker is good.
For Secret?
Yep. For Ricky, Io. These heroes are terrible against Spirit Breaker. He just charges with Dust. For Ricky, he just charges Io when team fights and ultis him, he's dead.
Like, so far, Secret's draft kind of looks all in on the push, really. If they don't get ahead, that's kind of hard. Oh, yeah.
Support Slider. Yeah. Okay. There we go. The beef we needed. Yeah, it's really good, actually. And Bane Slider roaming is terrifying for Puck. He just walks in with sleep, even though the range is kind of small, actually. I think he should be able to live unless he's like smoked at night time or something.
Still a spooky game for Timbersaw against Puck and Ricky.
Yeah.
Full of silence. Oh, Beastmaster.
Man, this PA is buffed up. I don't know though. Advillain's pretty all in on the early game, to be honest.
Like, yeah, they're aiming to get ahead.
Relying on PA to get a good start and Thug too. And then just like get Roshan and set the tempo from there. If they like get interrupted or you know they miss the first Roshan, I think this game could go pretty downhill pretty fast.
Yeah, definitely, because like Seeker will get, they have such a strong mid game out items.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And like Advillain just needs to get ahead of items, because if PA is forced into BKB after her vessel, it's like really, it's a bit of a game losing BKB, you know, like you probably might see it after this no matter what, but it's still like when you could go for something else, when you go for it by choice, it's usually a lot better than if you're forced to get it, because if you're forced to get it.
All right, let's get the important stuff.
It's like the only way you can actually be able to do stuff.
Number of teleports cancelled by stone by 25 minutes. 1, 2, 3+. I'm gonna go 1, because I think they don't have that many stuns at all. I'm gonna go 1. I'm gonna ignore your advice, Webbus. highest amount of physical damage a hero will do in one hit. Oh, PA's in the game. 750 to 1,000 seems pretty reasonable.
I can agree with that.
Highest net worth in the game. Alright, so if we pick PA, it's either going to be PA or Windrunner.
Yeah, I feel the same.
Could be Timber. There's a slight chance it could be Timber, but his lane is kind of hard.
I believe in the PA, man.
Actually, no, his lane's PA. I'm going to go with 4F. I believe in him. And Blink Daggers, 0 to 2.
0 to 2, probably.
0 to 2 by 24 minutes. 3 to 4.
I don't really like that Venom doesn't have anything to clear stacks. They can't really use Wisp with its full potential.
It's like Puck has to use their nukes and they're not really that strong. I mean, Skylark to an extent could, but it's not as efficient as what Sacred has in terms of like a Timber Snow.
They didn't even bother breaking the trees as well.
They're doing an offensive dual lane with PA and Io. Damn!
Did they expect the aggressive move, I suppose?
I guess so, yeah. And then 4F is just going to be up against this. Like, 4F should do completely fine against PA and Io, to be honest. That lane's not exactly spooky.
Well, plus Ricky.
Oh man, mid one lane, then the Law mid lane. I like seeing this when winners just get really offensive right at the start. Use wind run to trade hits really effectively. What do you buy? Clarity. That's for.
Skylar is gonna have a really rough game. Because of them running aggressive duo as well, if Skylar leaves to go jungle, Pi can just leave the lane to MP. MP can push the tower and he can just hunt Skylar constantly.
It's pretty difficult though, right? The amount of harass Brain Sap plus Drow Aura on Bane, he already does decent damage.
They're gonna be constantly pushing, that means if he gets like boots, and if he's fast enough to pull the groups away without dying, it should be fine for him.
That's true. Well, Pyla is in pretty deep here. Oh, no, he's
that's
dead!
A bit too deep.
Oh my god, what is he doing?
Pyla, what?
Yeah, he's fine.
He's fine.
Holy shit, he nearly got trapped by the creeps there and died. Hold, I was so worried. He's playing this to the...
That was too deep.
He didn't expect the axes.
Yeah.
The axes definitely surprised him. Holy shit, well played. I think that was too deep though. He really went ham there.
Yeah,
you can
like
see what
said,
he was trying to do.
Definitely wasn't expecting the axes there.
Oh, did you see the slaughter going for the rune? He expected Ricky to be there and stunned him without knowing that he's there.
Poppy, what a baller. Oh shit. What? Alright, in fairness to me, I did not expect Puck to die so early against Moonrunner. What, did he not phase the power shot? Is that what it was?
No, he tried to orb the second power shot.
Okay.
He was super low under tower, and then the phase shift, I think, came on cooldown. Right, I see you.
Okay.
It was just, you know, mid-greed. How mid players like to play. Stay as long as possible. Shouldn't happen, but, you know, it always happens.
It always happens.
You need to push yourself.
Well, so far, three heroes on Radiant are getting farmed. Pretty good for them.
Wait, this is by 10 minutes? I didn't read this correctly. Highest net worth by 10 minutes. It's definitely not going to be Timbersaw. Jesus Christ.
I mean, it depends. Forever's getting a pretty good lane. At the start, they harassed him down really low, so he had a back on the tower and regen. But after that, now when Poppy's down there, he's got some levels, they can't really do much to him anymore.
True. Lane, they're kind of, it's pretty passive so far, to be honest. There's a bit of poking at each other, but like maybe next time, not really getting what you really want as bounty hunter, right? You want to be able to rotate and pressure lanes, but at the moment it doesn't really seem like he's able to do that.
So hard to kill Timber now with two levels and reactive armor.
He doesn't
really
care.
Yeah, exactly. So much armor.
Oh, that was very close actually.
I think that's what Forev needs to do, just go for the Wisp. They can't stop him if he does so.
Especially with these early levels that he got.
Yeah. Permanent shield.
Assault, it's do a lot. Once he picks up Arcane Boots, they just can't really contest him in lane. He's gonna be level 6 before any of them. Because of how much experience he's getting and how Poppy's just helping out with Corn. So he'll be ahead of this trialing by a wide margin.
I'm pretty sure they should focus more on keeping the draw down. Because like a draw and Bane, you can punish that lane with Ricky plus Wisp rotating it.
They have a sentry place down. Ready for this though.
Still, you're pretty fast. Just jump on him, go in with Wisp, and just punch. Enough to get a kill. Oh, they are trying
Here comes the Ricky and the IO. Oh, do you mean the burst damage IO does actually... Oh. They managed to get a good sleep off.
Yeah. Didn't get
and
this slow.
And
they
have no way to cancel. Okay.
That's a good reaction. Very good.
Just sick play from Secret. Aware of the complete lack of stuns from Adfinum early game.
Yeah. So you get level 6 in your heroes, there's nothing.
TP, the greatest item in the game right now.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
No MP, they didn't get the memo of the TP.
Oh, no. That's body block though.
Oh.
Now he bought it.
Really good.
That's that a was kill, a weird. Though. That was a weird death, to be honest. Because he knew they were all there, right? Maybe
yeah,
just
he
assumed.
Also didn't pick up a TP from the side shot. But it's still pretty nice for Finn to be able to pick up
yeah,
that kill.
Yeah, it's good.
Skylar's gonna be level 6 soon. As soon as he gets that, he can probably rotate down to bottom and help Matter out. And they can see if maybe they can pick up a kill and pop. Brev is just getting a bit too far ahead. And that's the scary thing with if you focus on the draw, like there's you're gonna have your mid hero plus your top
Timbersaw,
player, most
yeah.
likely get a lot. And I think the Timbersaw is the scariest one.
Yeah, I guess Mana Boots now and soon level 6. You can't lane against him right now actually.
PA dies in like one combo, like 700 HP. She is so weak.
There's actually nobody that can go on that lane right now.
Oh man, this is a dream for Timbersaw. You know, get that solo safe lane against this really weak dual lane. Get kind of just get levels. That's all you need really on this hero. A little bit of farm here and there, and now he is free farming. Basically, he's nearly the highest CS in the game. Yeah.
I think him surviving that early kill attempt pretty much secured in the lane in terms of they can't get him back now because he'll get levels, and after that they just can't kill him because they don't have enough lockdown and they don't have enough damage until they get at least level 6 on the PA with some lucky crits or no face boosts.
Had Finnum just like we talked about how they need to be ahead going into the mid game, but it's not really working. Like they're falling behind on CS. They have to rotate their lanes. They kind of seem a bit all over the place. Mid one's power shot just barely misses mid or Thug mid.
Skylord is having a good time though. Getting a fast record could be really good. It's actually a way to kill the Timber if he gets that.
The Necro, yeah, the mana drain alone.
Definitely. And if they can have the Ricky there as well, with just a cloud afterwards, they should be able to bring Forev down. Burn's maxing is reactive though, that could be very tough to go through.
He just wants to sit here and farm, I guess, like.
Yeah, he just wants to get his bloodstone up as fast as possible. Just keep trying to steamroll from there on out, pretty much.
They're smoked up. Add Finnum looking for the Forev in the bottom lane here. They have Roar. They have Dream Coil. This should be an easy kill actually.
We should have the burst for this, yeah.
Forev's gonna be like, wait, where's it? No way. And he can TP?
Oh, the word.
Hit the reactive?
Oh. He missed the bolts. Oh god.
Oh my god.
So close. It was a bit too far at first and then too close.
Oh my, the just ball control was not on point. That was so
it was
close.
All over the place, man.
It was the 10 magic stick charge as well. I didn't fucking think about that. The stick did so much. It was like half his HP actually.
That's still pretty bad for your prediction, Shane. That means he can't farm for a few
that's
minutes.
That's true actually.
So Windrunner takes over.
In 1 minute. He needs to get like... What's the net worth? Let me see. Oh, he's pretty far behind actually. Oh wait, if he kills Beastmaster. Nice play, removing the sleep with the boar. Well, no. It's looking like Windrunner is definitely going to be the one with the highest net worth in this game. At 10 minutes in.
Getting a 25 damage increase is not too shabby when you're playing Midrunner.
Not really, no.
Kind of helps, especially against the Puck.
130 damage at minute 9.
Which item will Puck go for, by the way? Will he rush Rails or a Dagger?
I think you need a Dagger in this game. They have a lot of control, right? They have Silence, they have Shackle, they have Fiend's Grip, they have Sleep, Slider Stone. You know, they have so much control that you want to be able to get in and silence people, otherwise you'll... Especially from behind. Like, you don't have magic damage really, do you? You have your Puck stuff and then some balls.
Yeah, I think you need at least a Blink to be able to try and gank together with Skylark to make sure you get some room for Madara. Or at least get some, you know, Link Green Coil into relocate, so Madara can come in and help as well.
Yeah, that's definitely what you want, the Dream Coil relocate stuff, and...
Yeah.
if the game like continues at this pace, Adfinum are screwed. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, they need to pick up the tempo and like start taking control of the game, because right now Secret is just farming way more than them.
Also, getting the tier 1 bottom and the tier 1 mid is very important, because they want to try and get into that Roshan pit, get the map control over that side. Exactly. Like, they do Roshan really quick with the PA and the Beastmaster.
They just got relocate up, by the way, so let's see if they try to kill somebody with that, with Roshan plus
mid?
Relocate.
Maybe they go
smoke, smoke. They're gonna go with.
Nice, no, oh,
very
clean.
Good for Adfinum. Now Madara's got a cool up and the Blightstone that he had at the start, so this is a very good start for him. Or like, this is what they need to be able to catch back up. Okay.
Maybe next time, dying in the bottom lane?
Oh.
He didn't even have top.
Maybe a bit deep there, for that slaughter.
Oh no, okay. Oh. Damn.
A bit too late on the net worth.
Just so close. Honestly, I don't know how maybe next time died bottom lane. Forev didn't have dust.
I'm guessing he revealed himself under tower, trying to take the creeps.
Oh, only level one invis. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. So it's just way too long.
700 HP against the Timber, so.
Yeah. Might happen again, top. Well, not this time.
If them spells hit, I think he was pretty dead.
Yeah, he might have died actually. He does have a raindrop, so. Block some of the damage, but still a lot of damage coming out there. Spartan Thug's gonna go for a smoker. Thug's very close to his blink as well. If they can get a successful smoke here, or maybe one.
Oh, this is a difficult one. This is different.
Necro plus raw.
He has haste bottled, and they see the boss. Puppy's not really the kill they were looking for. But they can get the tier 1 terror off it. Oh. The TD? Or the greed.
If they get that windrun at some part,
I think he. If he can dodge. He can turn around for parachute and kill the PA?
Holy shit.
Alright!
That wish survived, barely. At least.
They have no mana for sleep.
Well, that's a disaster, actually. Raw down, Puck out down, Whisper down, still lost the fight.
They committed so hard to kill mid one that the Bane was just able to. Fiend's grip on the background and the power shot. Like it was.
Mid one. Oh my god. What were you saying?
Well, no, go on.
No, I was gonna say mid one breaking the smoke there under the ward as well.
Yeah,
very
yeah.
Important because he could back out and then come back in and help so Scarlet didn't get a proper ward.
I thought it was a bad idea to go back in, because like, I didn't expect him to do so much damage on the Beastmaster, but the second the Beastmaster got the roar off, I was like, oh god, this is a disaster, but he was tanky
he
enough.
Had a DD.
Yeah, he did have DD, yeah, but he also had the point booster, so he's so tanky.
Forev gonna have a 50-minute bloodstone. Scary.
This is a scary thing, but giving Forev him this off.
Yeah. It is.
It's his hero, you know?
That slaughter pick was so smart actually, aiding them into thinking they already have an offlaner.
It's very true. MP's just kind of doing whatever in this game, he's just trying to push top, chill. They do have relocate if they want to go on him, maybe next time. PA is bunching up beside IO, I'm pretty sure they want to go for this. But it has to be very clean, they're scanning the tower to see if there's anyone behind it. Oh, the gust. at least he got the turnaround kill. Let's see, probably might die too.
No, that's so worth it.
You think
that's pretty good for Adfinum.
It's very good. Drow and the bonus slider kill. I'll take it.
Only losing the Whispers, could Madara need as much as he can get. And right now he's got one of the Mythical Hammers as well for his Deso. Once he gets that, it's gonna be... I mean, they will be able to tear through Forev as well.
Yeah.
Be able to kill him off, which is good. Because if you can start getting kills on Forev now when you pick up this Bloodstone, it will be harder, but if you get it, you're gonna cripple him even more than what he has without the Bloodstone, because you really need those charges to keep snowballing as a Timberstone.
Looking at Madara now. I think he's at a pretty good pace right now in the game. He's happy enough with his farm. It's a bit behind, but the relocate kills have really, really got them back into this game.
Yeah, considering the start as well, being able to pick up this much is very good.
What do you go on Timbersaw now to prevent that you don't die to the ganks? Like, Yules?
Could just go Ghost Scepter straight away.
Oh yeah, that's actually true.
And then you pretty much just nullify the PA.
It's actually good against everything except Puck. Ghost Scepter.
Doesn't 4Ev like early Blink? He goes Blink straight away after Bloodstone, I'm pretty sure, most of the time with Timbersaw. It's very good against Relocate, cool. Right? You just...
Well, is it though, like, if there's a Ricky, you don't really have to take attack first.
That's kind of true. Alright. Secret's kind of like, are grouping up. They want to push in bottom.
200 gold to Desolate there. Okay.
Look at Skylark.
Oh, he's hiding.
What does he have in the career? Is it Necro 2?
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
MP's almost got his Hurricane Pike up.
Mid one's kind of low on health, but he does have a regen rune. Okay, good, good, good.
How did they stop the push?
The sandwich attack from Ad Finem here. Two behind and one on top.
I'm not sure if that's the play.
Aghanim's coming out as well. Oh my god.
He just randomly does that?
Yeah.
Did he feel the interrupt, maybe?
I believe the sentry and the ward in the jungle spotted him.
But still the timing.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, still very good.
That timing was
sick.
What's
even stun range? Like, so close.
Poppy. Damn.
Oh no,
Skylark. Oh, they want to go for Tug?
A good idea.
Oh, the phase shift!
Oh no. The disaster.
This is literally a disaster, yeah.
They forget about Skylark.
Oh, Puck. Wait, did he just forget that point that I was there? I'm so confused.
They also forgot that Skylark was still hiding.
Oh, he just TPs, right?
Yeah.
Damn. Alright, so what happened on the other side was Pylai die, went on Tug, but he phase shifted the ulti. And then Tug just kept on going because he's like, oh crap, I gotta help my team. And then Pylai die just followed him and just ultied him. It was really weird. Oh. Forev is not scared. Oh my god.
He went for plate mail, by the way, not Ghost Scepter.
Sometimes he goes double armor. Plate mail as well.
Yeah, I haven't seen Forev do it, but I saw Mind Control do it the other day. And it's pretty nice because you're. Most of the time, you're at least building a Shiva's.
Yeah, Shiva's and Lotus usually, right?
Yeah,
exactly. So you get the extra armor, especially against a PA that goes Deso. It helps a lot, and it's a very cost-effective item in general. I believe a lot of people always say that it's super cost-effective. That dust again.
Oh.
It's like when it comes to just armor and like...
How did he see that one?
I have no idea. I'm guessing he might have been spotted in mid somehow. Maybe went for some last hit or something in mid and then spotted him out again.
Poppy really doing work here.
Oh yeah, by the way, Puck really went dagger first and now he's going Spartan's for whale next.
Oh. Okay, he tried to save him but now he's dead too. Alright, can he time this?
Is he gonna try the TP or just tether? I'm gonna tether.
Forev's waiting for him though! Oh no. He's like, oh, I'm in a bad place, guys.
Oh, that roar was not necessary.
Yeah, that was very unnecessary. Now they can just destroy them in this fight, right?
God, these dusts, man.
Spoke loud. At least.
They don't have roar to control anyone now. They just go high ground, right? No? Alright, there's no mana on mid one.
Roche.
No mana to continue.
There's also no pressure on them. Like, they win late game.
True.
At this rate.
I'm gonna drink some tea over here so it doesn't annoy everyone. Alright. Honestly, tea is the best stuff in the entire world. He's gone for Yasha. On PA, that's unusual.
Well, I guess Manta style. Because of Slaughter ult, because of Silence.
Yeah.
Potentially even dodge Shackle.
It's good. It's good against Bane ulti as well, because you just manta this when he's about to use it, right?
Overall, yeah. It's pretty nice because it also increases your damage more than what a BKB would do, at least. So.
More, I think it's that's even close, to be honest. Let's see.
But it's also like I said, 96. If you're forced into the BKB, you put yourself in a pretty bad position. Like, yeah, you're gonna need it, but do you really want to get it that early? Because by the time it should be the most useful for you, it's already down to 5 seconds, so it's not actually not that useful. So you want to try and avoid the BKB as long as possible.
Until like super late game, then it makes...
Yeah, exactly. You want to try and get it as late as possible, especially on a hero like PA. And when you have a Wisp as well, Wisp can't tether to you if you have BKB. So if you BKB and try and get out, or need the Wisp to help you increase your damage.
The smoke is way too late from Secret.
Now that Roshan was really good. Very good timing. Yeah. Got them totally off guard.
Yeah, Secret, I think they were waiting on it because mid one was just sitting mid, waiting on Puppy to come out of the base with the smoke, but they just didn't expect it to be that quick.
Goes fast when you get that Dessa and the Beastmaster off.
Mm-hmm.
I believe they used the Necro Sword as well. Yeah, Necro Sword, yeah. So they kitchen sink to get that Roche down, but it's necessary for them to be able to take a proper fight. Hopefully they'll be able, I'm guessing they're gonna try and aim to get some pickups and then be able to take a fight, because I think in a full 5-on-5 it might be very hard for them, at least until they get Necros up. Once they get Necros again, should be somewhat easier, but it's just this Timber is gonna be very scary because you might need to use Wind Ranger.
Smoky at nighttime with Beastmaster Hawk. Puppy has Blink. Alright, nice, very clean kill. The Courier is taking a beating.
It's a DD with Ricky and still dead and one headed.
He doesn't have so much damage. He's kind of okay-ish farm wise, you know, drums, treads, magic wand. It's not the worst. But only two.
Actually pretty good considering.
Yeah, yeah, considering he's died 4 times. He only has 24 last hits, so I guess. The Roshan helped a lot.
Yeah, I think I also got one last hit on Roranger. For like 400 gold.
Relocate cancel by the shackle. Oh boy. So much damage on the backline as well.
Look at the draw. Is that?
And 4 Ev is a monster.
He's so farmed.
And they just back up, realizing there's no pressure, I guess. They have no draw, their push is a lot slower.
How do they fight against the Timber Soul with an axe now?
I don't know.
That's a thing.
That's why I was questioning the Yasha, right? You've got a Yasha. That doesn't, like, you're just going to implode.
He went back for a BKB now, though.
So oh, okay, thank God.
He picked up his myth. Yeah, he's got his.
Oh, he finished it. Okay, that's very. That's actually very fast.
He had his hammer and the recipe on the in the stash. But I still believe that it's. If you're war Timber, Windrun is just going to destroy you anyways. So it's, really just need to be able to get pickoffs to be able to actually kill this Timber. If they go for 5-on-5 fights, Timber, or like one of the three cores, are going to be able to do whatever they want. Unless, of course, they get a three-man coil and they all break it. But
yeah.
That's not very likely when you have a draw range and a wind range, because you're just going to send either side and max range.
This is the way Secret always plays, though. They're very, very greedy. But towards like this time of the game, like mid to late game, all of a sudden they do have what you talked about. They have these like three pretty high damage dealing cores, like kind of equal as well. You know, Drev does a pretty significant amount of damage, so does Windrunner, and Timber does a crap ton of damage. So it's very difficult to play around it. And then even Puppy is quite a huge part of their team fight as well. You're like low cooldown stuns, the amp, you know, it's difficult to say who you want to focus. Whereas if you look at Adfinim's lineup, you know, they have this IO that's pretty
bottom.
What was that? They used the BKB.
Oh, that was so next level actually. They dodged a gank and made their own gank with that same relocate.
That was sick. Oh my god.
That was pretty next level. Very impressive.
Damn! Adfinim. Trying to make something happen. If the silence off, there's no BKB on Drew. Okay. Or, PA.
So much damage.
Mid one just going ham on the puck as well. I think once the BKB was down and the surprise factor of the fresh BKB is gone, Secret are back kind of in control again.
Especially don't have too much. Such a low respawn on Timber.
He respawned instantly, right?
I believe like 10 seconds max and then he goes back in there.
How do they stop Fiend Script in the fights? I kinda have to use... Yeah, but it's hard. I kinda want to roar Timber and then smoke cloud him, so you only have kinda Puck ult left.
That's a dead man.
Timber.
Oh my god, the ghost and Timber saw. I take it all back, MP. I shouldn't have doubted you. I'm so sorry. I'm so fucking sorry, dude. Oh wait, never mind.
Oh, that's too greedy. Gonna have to stay around.
Oh man. That was sick as fuck, though.
Damn. So close.
That ghost and Timber side play was just. Oh yeah. Forever's actually a monster. He has to be.
He likes the Timber hero.
He just seems to know like the limits of it and know where to be, know how to rotate. He's just a monster. Like. It's terrifying.
And the only death he has is still a suicide. And now they're just forcing down two lanes. I mean, Fred's just standing punching with power on mid ones, crushing mid.
And that suicide as well was like the 10 second PKB on PA, like a relocate sick play by Adfinim, you know what I mean? Like, there was a lot of weird circumstances that made the.
Yeah, and then getting the quick respawn and getting a kill afterwards. Yeah. And they only lost out on 3 Godstone charges in the end, instead of like actually losing those 4 that they lost from the start because of getting the counter kills.
Yeah, I like what Tog is doing here. They know they're kind of behind and it's difficult to leave the base, so they just look for the relocate plays with the Puck Blink. They can do the same with Beastmaster, you know, you use the Hawk, maybe buy a smoke, you can solo smoke even, and just get the picks. You can always come back into the game with the IOPA, I think. It becomes harder and harder as the game goes on, but at the moment, like, they're definitely not out of it.
Yeah, you want to be able to use your BKB as much as possible now, since you had to pick it up so early. Just really utilize the charges and get as much as you can out of it, so you can get ahead. Because once the charges start going low again, Forever gets his Aghanims up, that's what he aims to go for. You're gonna die once that 5-second BKB runs out, so you want to try and get as much as possible out of it right now.
I'm also kind of sure they just lost as soon as Wingona gets her MKB. Can just hit PA and they can't stop her.
Yeah, that's actually it, really, isn't it? They have Roar. That's
and
it.
And you don't kill Windrunner in a Roar. Pretty sure they will.
Yeah, exactly.
No Roar and try roar and use a lot of things.
They could even
probably
sleeper,
just
you know,
gonna
they're
sleeper, roar. Yeah. And then you just Windrun afterwards and they can't actually kill off the Windrunner. God, probably with his Gust, that was so close.
Man. They have so many sentries just in kind of all the choke points. Come out up awards. Oh, they know. They're no, hungry, hungry hippos.
No dust really though, it's cooldown. 12 seconds since slaughter.
Oh, it didn't go for Roche. It's up in a minute. Alright. Maybe next time. Maybe setting up for F-top? No, I don't think he's enough to kill with the relocate. They need the Roar and the Puck, I'm pretty sure, to be able to kill, and the PA as well.
Yeah, double Timurza. Plate mail on Timber, so plus Aghanims now.
Yeah, double plate mail is legit, I'm telling you.
He's a monster.
Look at his arrow. Like, when he has no reactive charges, he has 26. Excluding the base.
Oh yeah.
Excluding the base regen, yeah.
It's literally insane. How'd they kill him?
Oh, wait, what? Oh, he killed the Hawk. Madara, cooldown TP. Alright, he should be okay. This Roshan is about to spawn in like a millisecond. Alright. Maybe they can kill Puck with the Fiend's Grip? Or the Shackle?
Oh.
Oh, well done, my puppy dog.
That damage.
Yeah. Really? Is that just Rax? The Fiend's Grip during the BKP? That's the 9 second charge as well.
And he can't tether.
He can't tether, yes. They're just kiting the shit out of him. Oh my god, Timber is eating him alive!
Oh, that was so quick.
Pilot died doing work in that fin fight. He catches out the BKB PA, Fiend scripts him, and then when PA like goes on him, he sleeps himself, and then just walks away. That was sick.
Doesn't F5, if they wanted to, they could pick Rex.
I think they just want Roche, right? Just
yeah,
be safe.
Yeah, exactly. They just play safe, I guess.
Get Aegis on mid one most likely, and then pick up the MKB and just stand on high ground.
Yep. Just buy it and then we're good.
Oh, I mean, they could just put Timber in front, punching the tower. And they can't do nothing about
that.
That's
12 seconds. That's very specific to how to fix the mouse. I wonder if he timed it every time it happens.
Yeah, he's like, he has this one issue that he practices to fix.
Stopwatch straight away.
No, maybe it's Puppy with the stopwatch.
Yeah. Only get plans 12 seconds.
I think it's been longer than 12 seconds.
And I feel bad for Pilot, like always. Like, they are winning so hard, 31 minutes in. Paladai has Tranquil Boots, one charge left on his
infused. Even the one charge on the raindrop just says it all, really, doesn't it? Yeah, but then look at Puppy's items. He's nearly got Force. He's kind of underfarmed too. Like, the supports in Secret definitely take a hit. You know, they try and pick these heroes that don't necessarily need items as supports. You know, you don't really see too many supports that buy Ags or any of that kind of stuff anymore. It's more like Bane doesn't need any items. He's happy with Tranquil Boots and a win list, to be honest. You know, what do you buy and get on Bane? Like a Glimmer Cape before stuff? That's about it.
Yeah, I don't see anything else. I mean, maybe a Ghost Scepter, but PA isn't really a problem for you anyways.
Just kite him.
Yeah, because they're never going to use any of the cooldowns to stop the Fiend's Grip. Unless, of course, you're standing on top of someone else when you're Fiend's Gripping. They might use the Smoke Cloud, but most of the times they won't have anything to break your Fiend's Grip, so you just stand there.
Smoke Cloud Timber, right?
Yeah. Or preferably they get rid of as many people as possible, considering they need to have
preferably,
CSGO pretty much the whole
yes.
team, you know?
No,
but yeah, I believe Bane is the main priority to put it on for sure.
You don't think Timber size? I think if Timber size doesn't have Smoke Cloud on top of him, your whole team's dead.
Yeah, probably.
Wait, the Smoke Cloud doesn't work on creeps. I didn't know that. The mist doesn't work on creeps. Did you know that?
Nope.
Oh, there you go.
I don't play Riku, so.
What
I do.
Puck? What's the boy?
I wonder if he's forced into Dagon here just to actually get damage.
Oh.
I guess I also need disable, so probably try.
Can they
to
even
get
can they even kill Forev?
I don't know. They just dust him again in mid. Yep, they did.
Wait, what, really?
Oh, well,
there's a DD boss. If they get that DD with Windrunner, they can just take Rex so easily. Or draw, for the matter.
I'm really disappointed in maybe next time, Ricky. It's also a lot to do with how Secret are playing it with it. Like, Puppy has been...
Oh, for F. I got him.
Oh, shit.
That's a lot of gold.
1,050.
It's 4,100 gold now. Can have
maybe
Hex
you
soon.
Even just go for Hex, yeah.
Yeah, you should go for Hex. They really need the disable.
Man, all of a sudden, Adfinim looking...
Well, that
it was a bait! It was a bait! Wait, what?
Not right, really, he's fine. Just getting out.
I thought they could have turned it around somehow.
No, too many TPs. It's too risky.
Mid one doesn't have a TP and Forever's dead. I don't know.
it's a DD draw ranger. He gets hit like two times on the wisp and he's dead.
True, true enough. Things. He is going for the hex, I believe.
He should go for hex. Fuck, I think.
Could be Lincolns.
Nah, like, I think they just lose if they go Lincolns.
It wouldn't be half bad for the PA, you know, just Lincolns him, he BKBs, he can do whatever he wants in a teamfight.
You need the extra lockdown though, that's really
they,
what you
they
need
definitely
in this game.
Need it.
They have way too many targets that they need to CC. I like the Madara's going in for the fashion now, even though it's mostly the standard build up, it's gonna really help them out, especially if you can get the Abyssal Blade up. Like, they're stemming the bleeding a lot. They're actually
they're doing very well, yeah.
Hold off a lot for now, so.
The thing I worry about
though is.
If
they can hold it off for another 10-15 minutes, they might be able to force it to more of an even game than it is right now. But they really need to be able to not lose too much when it comes to these Rex pushes.
They still don't have any way to deal with the Windrun, Windrunner. You know, like. He has Aegis, Windrun.
Shouldn't have used this ult on the tower, I think.
Well, that's
gotten,
a
like,
really low cooldown.
For that. So they lose a couple of seconds.
That damage. PA gets Fiend's Grip on the backline, they dream call at the interrupter. But it's too little too late, I think. Madara is taking so much damage from the mid one.
It's getting out though.
4-Ev is just going ham on everyone else. Oh, they caught out Puck.
Oh, they bought back on draw, they really want to push now.
Alright. They can actually get like 2 or 3 lanes. They have buyback on Puck, but none on Ricky or Io. The BKB is down on PA for 40 seconds.
They still have Aegis as well. It is safe.
Oh, that Bash Dagger!
Puck is dead again.
That's Aegis down? Okay, matter is. Puppy has Force Blink.
I think they still get out now, right? Or do they want more?
Can they go top? Yeah, they can go top. They have focus fire. They can at least get the tower. Without their initiation. And BKB should be up soon. Yeah, BKB is up in 5. This is pretty good, actually. Do they have Thirst? Oh, damn. BKB matter.
That Vindran.
I think he should have turned earlier.
Did they get that? They're getting. That's pretty good. Are they?
MP just comes out of nowhere. But the damage! Holy shitballs!
They really need to kill him. So
deny. Oh my god, all of that for a deny. What the hell's up? Should I turn that off? Thank you, Espo.
Bash. He needs to bash. Oh, he did.
My peak.
That was a buyback on draw.
That was not a buyback on the PA either, so that's actually very good. Only losing one Rax and tier 3 out of it.
You could see the
overall,
considering
the position you're in.
Very good, might be an overstatement, good. But.
I mean, considering the position you're in, right? Or considering the position that Finn is in, it's a very good hold. Because of them having Aegis on top of that, and Drow buying back, and you only. I mean, yeah, you lost the Beastmaster and the Puck in the buyback, so your Hex is gonna be stemmed. But for the situation, you still. Overall, the end of the like the end result is.
Yeah, I agree. I think,
with PA not dying, it makes it very good.
I like this walk. Yeah, skipping the Abyssal Blade and going for the MKB.
It's gonna help for sure.
Yeah, they definitely need that. Lotus finished.
I mean,
alright,
Secret's still so far ahead though.
There's a DD top again.
4-Ev's kind of peaked though, right? He's at his maximum power right now. Like he's only gonna stay the same for the rest of the game. Like he can't replace any of his items, I don't think. So
yeah, not really.
So Adfinim kind of have that going for them. You know, they can't buy any more items.
I mean, they still have room to grow, right?
They just need
to be able to hold it out. I feel another 10 minutes or so, and they'll definitely be more on even footing than they are now.
Their Defu Blade on Ricky gives him so much damage as well. Like, you don't really expect it, but it does do a lot of damage in teamfights. Puppy Ghost Scepter finished though. The problem is, when they start kiting with Ghost Scepters, it's gonna get a lot harder.
I mean, they could just send Runerunner up here right now and focus fire Rex. They didn't have fortify. How do you stop her? With Lotus Orb on her.
Fortification up in 40 seconds, so they have a window for sure.
I guess they're just gonna wait for Roshan though.
Safe. Play it safe, you know. You don't want to take too many risks.
The scary thing with playing it safe with Secret is the itemization on Drow. Going for both the Blink Dagger and the Silver Edge, it helps you summon damage, but it's mainly positioning, especially if you want to force high ground. Seeing him not go for the Aghanims right now, he'll probably go back for it and go for the Aghanims because the damage output is just so good if you push it later. But Adfinim might get a window where Drow might not be as strong as they want him to be, and PA might be stronger than what the Windranger is.
Yeah. Here's a smoke from Adfinim. Their lanes are kind of pushed out nicely. Oh man, this is going to be huge actually. They have the Beastmaster Hawk. The first Hawk's about to time out though. So, oh, I was out of position. Oh.
They're split.
They go in. Ricky goes in. BKB on PA. He wants to initiate. Mid ones focus him down with the focus fire and they get the Fiend's Grip off on him too. The amp on top. They get the stun off on Puck. He gets a phase shift just the last second with the Chakram. Is it enough? Oh, the blink! Well, Pilot that just shuts him down. And the backline MP is going ham. He gets roared and... Oh my god. Madara bought back and relocated in, and he's gonna focus fire with the amp! That's that!
Yeah, that's game.
Oh man, GG!
That
was rough. Very, very hard game from Adfinim. There was like... Their lanes didn't really go that well. They started off kind of slow. But they had a few really good relocates in the mid game that